Great. In the last lesson, we understood how to enable the X11 forwarding in PuTTY so that we can invoke the GUI interface. Now, there might be a concern like how can you by default enable it so that for every new session you don't have to go and enable the X11 forwarding. Yes, you can do that. You can see this default settings, right? This is also a profile. This is known as a default profile. So if you save anything in the default profile, that will be replicated to any new profile that you create. For example, let us go and check the X11 forwarding option for the default profile. Now, when you see nothing in this hostname and the saved sessions, that means your default profile is now loaded, okay? Now, in the default profile, what I will do is I'll go to SSH. I will choose X11. We can see that it is by default disabled. Now, I want that this option to be enabled every time when I connect to any server, whether it is default or when I create a new profile, automatically X11 must be enabled, because it will be again a challenge that every time you come, edit the settings and save the settings. What you can do is by default, you can enable X11. So what you need to do is, first of all, make sure in these sessions, you should not have anything. That means currently the default profile is loaded, and then go to connection, SSH, and then click on X11. Again, select this option, enable X11 forwarding. Then what you need to do is come back to session, choose this default setting and click on save. Now X11 is by default enabled. Whenever you try to connect to any server, for example, let me connect to a different server like 49.207.1.90, and I'm trying to connect to 167 server. Let us try to invoke the Firefox over here. Now let me just type Firefox, and this should invoke the Firefox from my Xmin. This way it becomes very easy for you to by default define the X11 forwarding. So in future you don't need to always go and edit the settings. So we can close this one, we don't need it. Close tabs. Okay, so we are back. Let me exit from the PuTTY terminal. So it's taking a little time to exit from the PuTTY terminal, or rather you can just click on X and click on OK.